tenor madness through the lens of the sentence. We are curious about how we can apply our thinking of the sentence or our analysis of classical music with the understanding of the sentence to other genres. And there's some things that I think you'll find apply to other genres as well. So first of all, let's just give a listen to Sonny Rollins and friends playing Tenor Madness. Okay. Now, let's look. Now that we've got that in your ear, you can hear some of these things that we're talking about. Okay, so the lens of the sentence, what does that mean? Well, it means that we're looking for a structure that has these three parts, right? There's this presentation of a short idea, maybe it's probably repeated, and then some kind of continuation where the material continues to spin out and dramatic tension is heightened, and then it gets resolved somehow. So let's look at what the parts of the presentation are, right? So it's a short focused idea. That's the main thing, right? It's usually stated twice and it clearly establishes the material. And we'll just, for now, we'll just call it X units long. I like to think of it as X units long rather than two measures long because that allows us to apply this thinking to different genres. Okay, what is the continuation? Well, the material of the presentation is extended somehow. Energy and activity, whether harmonic, surface level, rhythmic, those things are increased. Dramatic tension is heightened, right? So we're starting to tell a story. We're going on a journey, and it's about twice as long, or at least the units, it's about twice as long as the generating idea, understanding that the presentation material happens twice, so this is also 2x. Okay, and then the cadential idea. Something brings things to a close and dramatic tension is resolved, and it might be a very integral part of the continuation, as Kaplan talks about in his discussion of the expanded cadential progression. Okay, so how are we going to go about this? Again, we're going to apply the sentence lexicon to an analysis of Tenor Madness. Okay, so we're going to start with basic data collection, okay, just like you would do. Now, I like to go, even though I have an idea, I have a very clear idea of how this material relates to the sentence, in my analysis, I'm going to go down into the guts and collect the chords. Now, here in this lead sheet that I put together, I've used the lead sheet chords or the root and quality style chords, but we're going to convert those over to a Roman numeral analysis without figures. It's customary in jazz music not to use figures because we kind of think everything's in root position in a certain way. Not really, but also this is leaving it open for the bass player to actually create the bass line. Okay, melodic analysis. So now what I'm doing is I'm going through for each note and I'm determining the part of the chord that that note is. So here in this B flat 7 chord, D is the third of the chord. So I write a 3 up here. And this understanding of the relationship between the melody and the chord of the moment is an integral part to understanding how to improvise in jazz and to understand how other musicians have improvised. Okay, and then while I'm doing this, I'm making observations in my mind. I'm noticing voice leading, like for example, hey, the third of the chord here is now flatted and it becomes the seventh of the four chord. We know this from basic theory, but here it is playing out, right? The same figure, we do, is transforming and repeating, right? Even though the notes that it the part of the chords that the notes belong to is changing. Okay, now once I've done that, gone all the way to the end, I now go back to the beginning, and now I'm going to do another pass applying the lexicon of the sentence. So you see here, we've got our basic idea, right? And then it repeats. And the way it repeats is characteristic of a response or a statement and response, or what I'd prefer to call a call and response. Call and response is a way of understanding jazz music that makes a lot more sense than statement and response. Okay, and then I am thinking that this is a developed basic idea, right? We're continuing this idea and this idea, and now we're developing it, right? And again, here, look, it's twice, it's one, here's our X, here's our X again, and then here's about a 2X. Now again, I'm not trying to prove that this is a sentence. I'm using my understanding and the lexicon of the sentence to understand this song more deeply. Okay, and then it comes to a resolution. Now, it doesn't resolve harmonically. So I make a little note, right? It's the phrase resolves, but the harmony is not really resolving. I sort of have this perpetual tension, or you could even think that we're just getting going, but there's nothing harmonically which is resolving. So it's not a cadence by any stretch. In fact, now we have the whole thing repeated. Right, this whole bit repeats. So the initial pattern, basic idea, repeat, develop, basic idea, and resolution, that itself repeats. Okay, and now here is a cadential idea right down here, which I connect to the idea of a turnaround. But it definitely is a cadential idea, bringing the harmony to a resolution right here. Now this is where I think it gets really interesting, because here, even though the harmonic energy has resolved, the melodic energy continues, which we'll get back to in a second. So zooming out, I'm making another pass at the next architectural level up. The presentation is, there's a police car outside. The presentation comprises the basic idea and its repeat. The continuation comprises this developed basic idea and its resolution. And then, of course, those things happen again. Right? Okay. And then the whole resolution happens here in the last four measures. So now I'm curious, going back to what I was just alluding to here. Here, the harmonic energy ends here. Or does it end here? So I'm making a note. Nothing like a good old question mark to make your day a little easier, right? So the dramatic tension, does it release here partly? Or is this right here, is this our authentic cadence? Is there a half cadence? Is there an authentic cadence? Does the idea of cadence even really apply at all? Because here's something really, really that I just think is awesome to note. The harmonic energy resolves here, but the melody continues. And while the melodic energy resolves, this other cadential progression emerges, which propels the ear to return to the top. And that really serves one value that's part of the blues form and jazz form more broadly, is that we have a cyclical harmonic progression. It repeats over and over again, allowing improvisers to make their own statements. Okay, so again, we have this sort of schism here. Melodic energy ends way over here, even though the harmonic energy kind of comes to a pause and then restarts itself to get us back here. So I maybe could put an AC here. I don't really think the idea of cadence applies here in the same way as it does in classical music. All right. So again, I'm not saying tenor madness is a sentence, right? We are using our curiosity and our growing understanding of these design patterns that we hear across genres. And in this case, it's a short, long resolve. Okay. So we're thinking about how they might apply, the short, long, how does that apply to this other genre, right? How is it different? Well, it's different in that there's sort of two layers of things. There's the short, long, and then the fact that that's repeated kind of makes the short, long its own short. And it helps me to understand both genres a little bit. Okay, now it's your turn. Have fun.